Well, good morning, YouTube. We are headed out to the sawmill. But first, we gotta feed Miss Princess. Warning, this is slightly violent. Okay, calm down. All right, she took a huge chunk, so we're not gonna really see her eat. Usually she just grabs it out of my hand here. Slow down. Slow down. I had to cover up most of it with my hand so she wouldn't take it all at one time. You don't have to eat so fast. All right, it's all on the ground. No, I'm good. I don't have any more. All righty then. Good morning, sir. Let her out. Maggie, did you roll in the mud? So, today we've got a fairly large piece of white oak. It's not that long, it's only maybe 4 foot long, but it's wide, it's big. So, as soon as we get done letting the animals out, we're gonna give that a go. And we might even have the missus come help us. I did some boards yesterday that were huge. Not huge, shouldn't say that. They were a little too much for me to try to handle by myself. So she came out there and helped me. And she said she'd come help us again today. Good morning. How's everybody? Can I get back here? Oh, that's my finger. Nope. All right. One goat got out. We'll get her. Good morning, Hamlet. How you doing? Dirty self. Let's see if I can get everybody running out. It's kind of my favorite part. There's Finnegan the sheep. There's Vidalia, Penelope. And I don't keep up with the goat's names. Well, I know that one's Mo, the brown one. All right, we gotta go get this goat that got hung. You know, the one sitting here on top of the pile of hay, just loving life. All right, I'll be back. This is a two-hand operation. All right, YouTube, we're back here at the wood mill. So we've got this 33-inch wide log on the mill, but we don't have it quite positioned the way we want it. We also have Mrs. Little Windy Hill here with us today. So she's going to be helping us try to get this thing positioned and then cut and then put on the, turn the slabs over. So right now we are not positioned where we can cut it because it's sticking out too far on this side. So we need to move the whole thing over. I tried pushing it a minute ago and it moved the whole mill. So we're going to try to pick it back up and we just need about 2 inches over this way. So I'm gonna pick it up
So white oak. So that's what we're looking at. It's already got some cool grain pattern on it. So we're gonna keep going. We're gonna start taking slabs from here on out. Yeah.
Log like this, I have to empty it every cut. That's why I just go ahead and shut it off.
Yeah.
Because when it's a mental thing for me. If the motor's running, I'm like, oh, I gotta hurry.
Yeah.
This is not something you want to hurry with. It's just like strain yourself too much. And plus, I want a lot of this to be somewhat relaxing,
Yeah.
About 2 inches from the edge. Let's take a look at that. So now we're getting into some darker grain. But my saw blade is moving quite a bit during the beginning of the cut. And I think it's because this thing is wiggling. So, I think the best thing to do is to go ahead and flip it. That way we've got a sturdy base. Do is we'll take those two and set them over here.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry. I there is no. You remember how I said this was a learning channel?
Yeah.
I'm learning. So if I do something, sometimes I gotta back up and punt.
Well, I'm gonna be asking questions.
Yeah. Well, did you notice the log was moving quite a bit?
No.
It didn't. Huh?
No.
Don't worry. I'm moving these by myself. I don't want you to get hurt. It's looking pretty.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. You want to scrape it? Today's video is sponsored by Little Windy Hill Farm. Bring your family out.
No, keep going.
Bring your family out for a fun day on the farm. We've got chickens and ducks, mini zebu cows. We've got a horse, ponies, Nigerian dwarf goats. We've got a baby doll sheep, and we have the most beautiful little pot-bellied pig this side of the Mississippi.
Is that what you
would call him? He's so cute.
I would call him ornery and wiry.
All right, so you know how I was saying I want to get a router sled table
To
flatten the slabs?
Yeah.
Run your hand across that right there, and that's why. So when you go from this, like the harder the wood, it gets harder and the blade moves more. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I want to get a flat and hopefully rectify that.
Morning chores have started.
We'll take a small break here at the Little Windy Hill Sawmill and show you some of the chores that gets done in the morning. Nope, can't see him.
Well, our kids are up there. Is Sarah getting the chickens out, or is she leaving them up?
She's just feeding them.
Oh, just so we're, the girls are feeding the chickens and the ducks. All the other animals just eat grass. Birthday parties,
company picnics,
we'll do private tours,
field trips
for your daycares and your schools. Do it.
Goat
yoga. I do not participate in the goat yoga. Get the kids' picture on the tractor.
Unicorn photo shoots.
The great goat mythologist, Kim Porter. And her crazy husband, Chuck. Oh, that's me.
Put the arms down the back side. Probably ain't a bad idea before we get too much wood on there. Oh! Oh wow, I got a little, nice little knot forming. Let's see, it's flipped over here. You know what we should do? We should do the YouTube water splash.
Okay.
Let me get the water. If we were outside, we'd automatically be doing the YouTube water splash. I mean, look how it has that defined black line in the green. It's almost like a flame. And you got this little squirrely looking knot over here. Alright, so we're going to have to put these down, and that is not moving at all. You hear that cant hook over there?
Yeah.
Somehow we got to get this log off of the arms. So these little white plastic things right here, these are scrapers.
Oh, okay.
So they scrape the, all right, so we're 11 3/4 back down to 11 3/4 10 3/4 9 3/4 I'm going to take an eighth off the blade. 9 5/8 Problem is, this thing is so wide, I can't clamp it. So, let's see what happens.
Why? What made it ugly?
It just, I felt it wiggling.
Okay.
These are going to make some delicious coffee tables. Pretty good.
Yeah. It's a nice size.
It is a nice size. It's pretty good. Do the scraping this time.
All right. Well, we got Mrs. Wendy Hill over here. She's gonna get in on some action. Oh, that's pretty. Oh, oh, sweetheart, oh, you got to do the reveal.
Oh, this is like the big one.
Monster. Oh, yeah. That's a pretty one. Well, we're getting there.
About the 9 5/8, go up to 10 5/8. If you look at this, is my one. I can't remember if this bug saved my life. Of course, you get down so low, you can't use the bucket. Alright, so back down to 9 5/8. 8 5/8. 7 5/8. Take an 8 then one.
You want something to drink?
Yeah, I brought water.
Here, I have this.
Okay.
Do you want some?
Well, of course. I mean, it's a sawmill. It's gonna be dirty. Thank you. maybe. Oh, now why? We caught the pith in that one. No, no, we caught it on the edge. Oh, that stinks. That means that it's more than likely going to crack where the pith is at. And you try to isolate the pith to one board. Let's see down there. See right in here and right up there? That's the start of the pith. So that means that this board is going to crack. And then this board, the next board we cut, is probably going to crack. Because this should have the whole pith in it. Alright, so we are at 7.5, 8.5. Pretty good. See the pith? So this is the center of the tree. And this tree was a little baby, that's where it started right there.
Everybody runs to the
bottom
and just like,
whatever. Because he doesn't even feel it. Oh, that looks heinous.
Did I step on your toe?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. I put myself right there. Seriously, this is like the perfect width for coffee.
Oh, gosh. That looks bad. Horrible. Yeah. You scrape it, or you cut it.
We'll try it. Is this a learning
panel? Oh, you know what? You want to stop after this log?
Mm-hmm.
You want to cut another log after this?
How thin can you cut it? Like, can you, like... Because, like, wouldn't that...
I feel it.
Well, I'm asking, because, like, wouldn't that be neat to, like, wrap that around the outhouse? Like, the thin...
Well, my thought behind that was, you know how we did the shiplap? How we didn't really do shiplap, we just bought that quarter-inch board?
Yeah.
And is to cut some quarter-inch pieces like that and put them up on something and see what it looks like.
Like my outhouse?
No, you don't want to do that on the outside.
Well, I mean, just for...
Oh, on the inside, you mean?
Either way. That's what I was just asking. Like.
This one's going to be heavier, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Oh, wait, that's supposed to come out.
Well, that'll be fun.
Use your hands, sweetheart.
Well, I'm afraid it's going to hit me. Even bigger?
Should be about the same size. got to help me get these things centered. See how we got off down here? That looks off the board. All right, you scrape that off. I'll get some more stickers.
There's more stickers right there.
Where? Yeah, but I need three more. There's a big difference between watching YouTube and telling people how they're going to get hurt and actually doing it. Sticker first. You guys have seen the Kubinex strapping before, so we'll keep you from that. I think that's all we're going to do today. That is 10 slabs. Now I didn't capture the pith in one slab, so two slabs have the pith in it. So we probably only got 8 slabs out of that. But we will we'll strap that up and get it stacked, and eventually we'll see how that does. All right, if you enjoy these videos, please hit the like button. If you don't, just scroll on to the next one. YouTube's got a bunch of them. And subscribe and share them with your friends. Thank you. See you next time.